Thank you all very much, and thank you all for being here on day 2,923. As these days pass, I'm reminded of the story about a very crabby, very old woman who came before the judge and said, "Your Honor, I'd like a divorce from my husband." "How old are you?" the judge asked. "I'm 92, Your Honor. My husband is 94. "How long have you been married?" "Well, Your Honor, in March it'll be 74 years. Do you know we have 6 children, 23 grandchildren, and 27 great-grandchildren?" Well, the judge was rather amazed by all this and said, "Well, man, why on earth would you want to get a divorce now?" She said, "Your Honor, as far as I'm concerned, enough is enough." That's not how I feel. My friends, it is time, and I'm delighted as one of my last acts as president to bestow the Citizens Medal of 38 deserving Americans. And all of you, whether you've been in government service or served your country as intellectual and spiritual lightning rods for democracy and our great tradition, are indeed deserving. And I'd particularly like to thank a man of great courage who is truly an inspiration to us all and to all Americans, our outgoing press secretary, Jim Brady. I think you'll agree with me that one of the great privileges in our society is the privilege to serve the public good in public service. These days, all these retrospectives of our time in Washington suggest I came here to abolish the federal government. That's foolish. I never had such a goal for the federal government. I just believed it was too often unresponsive to the world beyond the Beltway and that some of its personnel were too interested in offering the American people instruction instead of taking their instructions from the American people. It was one of my primary goals to restore public confidence in the government and the process of governing. And if I was successful, it's due in large measure to many of you in this room who set about your task with an understanding that we're here to serve, not to rule, that we're all employees of the American people. And as you leave, I think you've all gotten a pretty good job recommendation, not from me, but from America. So I thank you all, and may God bless you, and now it's my pleasure to present the medals. David Abshire.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you for everything. Richard Armitage. I suppose I should open it for you if I can figure out which way it opens. I didn't the first time. There. Thank you. And Arnold, Beckman. Thank you. James Scott Brady. Chester A. Crocker. You see, I'm a little clumsy yet. That stitch is taken out last night. This is Arthur B. Culvahouse, Jr. And Ken Duberstein. Feulner, Jr. Max M. Fisher. Oh. Arnold R. Fortier, posthumously awarded an Allison Fortier. Excellent. Charlton Heston. And Russell Kirk. Kampelman. And Herman Kahn posthumously, Jane Kahn. Don Hodel. Marsh, Jr. And McLaughlin. Colin Powell. And Arnold Lewis Rayfield, posthumously Nancy Ely Rayfield, etc. Rozanne, Ridgeway. Rowny. Stuart K. Spencer. William H. Taft IV. Richard H. Truly. John C. Whitehead. Charles C. Wick. Joseph B. Wright. Well, it would be impossible to total up and be, we'd be here for quite some time if I tried to go into the merit of each one of these individuals and why the presentation of these medals, but believe me, they were all truly earned and deeply deserved. So now, one of us has got to get back to the office. Thank you all.
I think Reed would commit suicide.
I should be very formal and say Vernon Walters and here. And believe me, no one has deserved it more than you have for all of your service to this country.
Thank you, Mr. President. As I said, thank you for what you did for all of us.
Well, I thank you.
None of us will ever forget you.
You've been doing a lot for all of us for a long, long time.
Thank you, Mr. President.
All right.
May I introduce my nephew, Peter Adams?
Mr. President.
Your pleasure, sir.
Well. That's like a regular chip off the old block.
Bigger chip. And my chief of staff, Commander Martini.
Mr. President.
Hello.
Nice to see you, sir. Thank you for everything you've done for the United States Navy.
Well, thank you. I said that wrong. I meant to say a regular block off the old chip.
Commander Martini went into Ethiopia with me. We got out that CIA man, you remember? A couple of years ago, we got that CIA. He went in with me, and he had to sedate the man and keep him quiet so he wouldn't jump out of the airplane.
For heaven's sake. Well, that was quite a story.
Thank you.
I want to be proud of. All right. Well,
thank you.
Very nice.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you for everything.
Thank you.